Last week during our Python for Delphi webinar, there were some questions about how to get everything installed and set up. So I'm going to walk you through installing Python for Delphi, Python, and SynEdit. So we'll start with SynEdit. It's available in Git. Eventually, Python for Delphi will be in there too, but we're not installing it from there today. Except the EULA. It's now going to download SynEdit and then build all the packages for Windows. So it's installed with IDE and ready to go. That's it. We're done. So now I'm going to install Python for Delphi. To do that, I have to come in here and get the URL for the repository right here, and then go to RAD Studio, open from version control, git, source, destination, make a folder to put it in. And now it's gonna ask me what project I wanna project or project group I want to install or want to open after the installation. And so I'm going to go ahead and open the package right there, Python for Delphi. I can build this in theory. Yep, builds it just fine and install it. There's only one package right now and so everything's been installed. But in order to run anything, I need to install Python for Windows. Now, he recommends the Python 3. Now, there were some questions about redistributing Python. So if you want to redistribute Python, you can just redistribute the, download the embeddable right here, embeddable zip file. And that would be the minimum. That's like 7 megabytes for that one. I think it's 8. Actually, it's 8 for that, 7 for that possibly. I'm going to go ahead and do the full installer though. And you want Python 3, not Python 2. Python 2 is very old at this point, and he recommended you get Python 3. So Python 3 finished installing, or finished downloading, so I'm gonna run the installer. And I think actually you can install it from the Windows Store as well, but I'm not positive. Install now, yes. And I'm installing the 64-bit version. The I could install the 30-bit version as well, but I'm going to just build Win64 applications and use the 64-bit version. So the bitness of Python has to match the bitness of the program you're building. And if you wanted to deploy it for macOS or Linux, you would need to install the Python for those platforms as well. You could embed the embeddable version for all three platforms in there, although I think most Linux distros have it by default, but that's not true. They don't. It's optional. You can install it through the Linux package manager. So pip is the Python package manager that you can use to install Python packages. If you want to install like NumPy or TensorFlow or something like that. Apparently my path is getting long, so we'll go ahead and disable that limit so I don't run out of path space. Always running out of path space. Okay, so now I'm in RAD Studio, so I'm going to go ahead and open the demos. And demo 31 is the one that he showed off during the webinar. And you know, I'll go ahead and save changes to that. So this is SynEdit. Actually, this is a memo. Oh, this doesn't have SynEdit on here. This is just using memos. Actually, if we go back to here and go into demos, let's see if one of these is using. Nope, none of these use SynEdit. So SynEdit gives you the syntax highlighting, but none of these are just using SynEdit. Interestingly, I thought they did. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and run this and error. Definition Inc. File not found Definition Inc. Should I want to explore? I'm guessing it's in source. Definition Inc. Yep. Copy. I need to go tools options. It's all of my Python for Delphi library needs to be added to my path. I need to go to the library path. And it's got SynEdit added automatically, but because I didn't install it from Git, which no, I didn't get it yet, so I'll add, there we go, and now. It should build. Okay, so I'll run this. Execute. Ah, there we go. So this is the, okay, this is the one that shows how to use Python to build a GUI application. Can close, close. Dialogue. All right. Yeah, that was the last one he showed. So let's open up a different project. Demos. Demo one. We'll start with one. Okay. Again, this is just a memo. And a memo. Yeah. Execute script four. So that's just a really simple one there. Although let's go ahead and replace this with a synedit. Not that I can't rewrite that. And we'll go syn edit. And we need to say, spell it right, Python. So we need Python behavior and Python syn text highlighting. And then here we say we want highlighter is Python and the behavior needs to point to the editor, syn edit there. So now we see we got the blue on the numbers there. And we're just gonna, actually, let's just do this. I'm gonna cheat and just rename this guy to memo1. And now, cross our fingers, let's see if it works. Yep, so now it all works. So I've just replaced that with synedit. So synedit gives you the syntax highlighting, also gives you the behavior, so it knows how to do the indentation and stuff like that. So if you had multiple versions of Python on your system, notice I'm building Win64. If I was trying to do Win32, let's go ahead and do that now. It should fail. Let's see. Oh. Library path. Add. There, save. Now it should build, but it shouldn't run. Now it's failed because it can't find python32.dll. So, and that gives me an error message. And that's because I didn't install Python 32, I only installed Python 64. So if I wanted to install both, I would have to put both of them on there. Or if I wanted to build Win32 ones. But then also, if we go into design, oops. Accidentally close that. If we go in here into the designer, here is the Python engine. Okay, and the Python engine is where you can specify things. So use last known version is what the default is. If you wanted to, you could use a specific version of Python in here. DLL name, sorry, here is where you can specify a specific version of DLL, specific path, etc. So there you go, quick introduction to setting up and using Python for Delphi. If you don't have Git installed on your computer, so you have to go install Git, and let's see, options. So you have to have Git installed and the path set up in here. If you don't have that, then from here, you can just download the zip file or use GitHub for desktop to do it. And for some reason, they've now got a GitHub command line interface instead of how it used to have, they had the Git command line. I don't know when they changed that. And now I get this weird, strange pink error box at the top. So yeah, you can just download the zip file if you don't have Git installed on your computer. There you go. That's a quick introduction to setting up and using Python for Delphi.